I was doing a bit of research for a list of the scariest enemies in the Mario series, and I found out that a bunch of people kept talking about the infamous eel that is located in Jolly Roger Bay. While I did put this eel on a list like that a long, long time ago, I think it's time for us to finally take a good look at this supposed enemy. Because as you'll soon realize, the bad guy is not always who you think it is. Hey, I'm Nico, and here's why the eel is not a bad guy. So, it is no surprise that the eel might be scary looking at first. After all, pretty much everyone's first encounter with it was in the depths of Jolly Roger Bay, down in the sunken ship. And sure, I'll give it to you, these big teeth are quite spooky at first. But once you get past those and realize that the eel doesn't really want to eat you, you'll soon see it can almost be kinda cute to look at. I mean, take a look. Let's add a bow tie and a top hat. And now, all of a sudden, instead of a scary beast, you're looking at a very sophisticated sea creature. And that's pretty epic. In New Super Mario Bros. DS, the eel appears in a couple of levels. And most of the time, it's just swimming in the sea, minding its own business. Sure, if you're in its way, you might get bitten by it. But let's be real, who's out of place in this picture? The Cheep Cheep? No, it's a fish. It's in the water. The eel? No, it lives in the water. The overall whirring plumber that shoots fireballs all over the place? Bingo! This dude doesn't deserve to be there with the eel and all of the fishes. Eels need water to live, so it is a given that they live underwater, and since the sea is their home, they are free to move wherever they please. I hear you, you're going to tell me that some of the eels are actually trying to attack Mario by hiding in these little holes and attacking you as you get close to them. But let's be honest, can you blame them? What would you do if a random dude would come near your house and get close to you? You'd definitely react the same and would try to protect your goods. Plus, a bunch of those eels are actually small babies, as you can see by their size. You wouldn't attack a baby eel, would you? Come to think of it, the first time you see the eel, it's hiding inside of a sunken ship. Why is there a ship at the bottom of the sea in the first place? That is some pollution. And after that, you have to get a power star that's stuck on the eel's tail. Poor dude, that's gross. I do not believe that the eel is a bad guy. It's kind of just a casualty of the ocean, rivers and beaches being filled with trash. In fact, pollution from plastic has created a health crisis for the entire planet. And this is why we need to do something about it. This is what Team Seas is here to do. With the help of Mr. Beast, Mark Rober, and thousands upon thousands of your favorite content creators, such as myself, Team Seas aims at raising awareness and money to help solve this problem. A couple of years ago, you remember there was Team Trees, and it was a success. We planted over 20 million trees, and now we will tackle another problem together. So, the goal of this campaign is to raise $30 million in order to remove 30 million pounds of trash from the oceans, beaches, and rivers. That's right. With one single dollar donation, we get rid of 1 pound of trash, and that's quite a lot. So imagine 30 million. So if you want to make a difference and join this amazing cause, well, check out the link in the description or visit teamseas.org. And the rules are simple. $1, 1 pound. $2, 2 pound. Three, you get it? Easy. And as for me, well, I'll be seeing you this weekend for my spooky Halloween video. So, bye-bye. The eel is not a bad guy, okay?